Next on Wood Songs, we're coming to you from Dublin, Ireland, celebrating the Irish roots of bluegrass music with Wee Banjo 3 and many others.
We all need more kindness in this world. We all need more kindness in this world. You can look high or low, but there's no place else to go. We all need more kindness in this world. We all need more loving in this world.
Wood Songs is made possible in part by Altec, makers of Kentucky Bourbon Barrel Ale. More information is online at KentuckyAle.com. And by Tourism Ireland. More information available at Ireland.com. By Time Warner Cable, providers of telephone, television, and high-speed internet nationwide. And by Kentucky Tourism. Information is online at KentuckyTourism.com.
Here on the Louisiana Hayride, his name is
Hank Williams,
the Drifting Cowboy.
On the Grand Ole Opry,
Bill Monroe and his Bluegrass Boys.
Hi, this is Bruce Hornsby.
Hi, this is Kevin Moore.
Hey, folks, this is Bela Fleck.
Hi, folks, this is Sam Bush.
Hello, this is Odetta.
This is Joan Baez, and you're listening to the WoodSongs Old-Time Radio Hour.
And now, gather the family around and sit back in your easy chair. It's time again for the WoodSongs Old-Time Radio Hour, our worldwide celebration of grassroots music. Let's welcome folk singer, author, and tree hugger, Michael Jonathan.
Sitting on a creepy old rocking chair. They say it's gonna rain, but we don't care. Laughing with you all afternoon on the front porch with me. Waving to my neighbor as they're passing by. Cooking up some chicken, bacon, apple pie. Pretty as a rain cloud in the sky on the front porch with me. Listen to the rhythm of summer rain, tapping out a tempo on my window pane. Nothing like summer on a front porch swing, making my banjo ring. I'm playing my banjo on a rocking chair. You can play your fiddle in your underwear, pretty as a rainbow in your hair when you're on the front porch with me. Here we go, Tabitha. Listen to the rhythm of the summer rain, tapping out a tempo on my window pane. Nothing like summer on a front porch swing, making my banjo ring. I'm playing my banjo on a rocking chair. They say it's gonna rain, but we don't care. Dancing with you all afternoon on the front porch with me. When you're on the front porch with me. When you're on the front porch. And welcome everybody to the beautiful Convention Center in Dublin, Ireland. It's nice to have you all here. Thank you very much. You guys are great. We are here celebrating independent and grassroots music in the beautiful country of Ireland, one of the only nation on earth that has a musical symbol as its national symbol, the harp. So it's a very musical people with a huge musical heritage, and it's only fitting that WoodSongs could come here to celebrate the music of this beautiful country, and especially as it relates to the music of America. And specifically, we're here celebrating the music of bluegrass music, and folks really don't recognize that back in the early days, this guy that created bluegrass music, his name is Bill Monroe. back in the days of Kentucky and Rosie in Kentucky. You all recognize the voice, right? Bill Monroe. Well, what he was doing back in the days of his early childhood and stuff with his family and uncles and aunts, they were playing fiddle tunes based on Irish and Scottish traditional melodies. And he added his mandolin to it, and later on, Earl Scruggs, the great banjo player, joined the Bluegrass Boys, and that is what became bluegrass music. And so there's a huge connection between this global art form and what your home nation has as traditional music. So that's what we're going to be looking at. And in order to do that, we invited people from all over Ireland, artists from all over, to come and represent the Irish form of bluegrass and music and traditional Irish music. The first folks up that we're going to have do this are wonderful fellas, four guys, two sets of brothers. They just opened for Mumford & Sons, and now they're here on our broadcast. They are doing a very unique kind. I want all our listeners out there to recognize that they're not playing a normal five-string banjo. They're playing a four-string banjo. So listen to this very closely from their CD, Roots of the Banjo Tree. This is a medley of Bill Cheatham. Please welcome We Banjo 3 to the WoodSongs, Old Time Radio.
Thank you.
From their CD Roots of the Banjo Tree, Martin, Enda, David, and Fergal, We Banjo 3. Weren't they wonderful? Now they're your form of bluegrass. We are going to talk to them at length in the second half hour, but let's kind of analyze this this American bluegrass and Irish traditional music connection a little bit more. Let's welcome Niall Toner to the stage. Niall is a... How you doing, Niall?
Hi, Michael. Good to be here.
Niall, you are sort of a patriot of bluegrass music in Ireland. You have a bluegrass show on RTE One. You've been playing bluegrass almost all your life. And Bill Monroe absorbed the traditional sounds of Ireland and Scotland that became his music, that became bluegrass.
As you said, and I was privileged to fall in love with the music of Bill Monroe when I was just a youngster in Harold's Cross. I got introduced to his music, and I think I became an instant convert, and I've followed him ever since.
You actually got to meet him and chat with him?
Several times. Yeah. I was privileged to meet him about four or five times, and in fact, we played a couple of tunes together. At one point, he taught me a tune called The Chilly Winds of Shannon, which he said was for the people of Ireland. So he kind of made me the keeper of the flame, in a way.
So how do you find in Ireland right now the bluegrass audiences? It's certainly a growing art form.
It's a growing audience. There are more and more little festivals cropping up all over the country, and it's a very, it's a difficult enough music to play. It takes a lot of dedication in the way that jazz does, and it's not hugely financially rewarding, but it's great fun to play.
Well, you're just pointing out that most bluegrass and folk artists are just making tens and tens of euros.
That's about it.
There is a reason folk rhymes with broke. That's what we say on the show quite a bit. But now, are you finding a nice audience reaction, say, on your own personal radio program on RTE1?
Very good, very positive. Yeah, I've been doing it for a number of years, and currently do a show called The Roots Freeway on Saturday night, which is very broadly based. So we play everything from bluegrass to traditional Irish music, and lots of singer-songwriters, roots music of all sorts.
Well, as an art, not just as a radio presenter and someone who supports bluegrass music, but as an artist, you have your own album out. It's released on a label in North America, which is an honor. Very few artists get to have record companies behind them anymore. And you're going to perform a song that you wrote sort of as a tribute to Bill Monroe.
Yes, I paid a visit to the annual Bill Monroe Festival on Jerusalem Ridge in Kentucky a number of years ago, and I wrote the first chorus there about 7 years ago, and then it took me another 7 years to write the verses and just released it on the album, on the Onwards and Upwards album.
So from his CD, Onwards and Upwards, this is his song called William Smith Monroe. Please welcome Niall Toner to the WoodSongs Old Time Radio Hour.
From Kentucky, learned tunes from old Black Ben. Sang songs with Birch and Charlie, playing guitar with Uncle Ben. Tore up the Grand Ole Opry, and he shook up Music Row. The cross-eyed boy from Rosine, William Smith Monroe. On their very first audition, before the old Judge Hay, showed those Opry folks how they could really play. That stern old judge told Bill if he ever wished to go, he'd have to fire himself from the Grand Ole Opry show. Now I hear his voice a-calling from somewhere in the pines, and that high, lonesome tenor sends a shiver down my spine. I walk the piney woods where peace comes dropping slow, all alone with the ancient tones of William Smith Monroe. For 50 years and more, Bill rolled the bluegrass line with Flat and Scruggs and Baker, Mack Wiseman, Curly Klein. this man the music who passed through his hands. Still carry on the sound of Monroe's bluegrass band. Now I hear his voice a-calling from somewhere in the pines. That high lonesome tenor sends a shiver down my spine. As I walk the piney woods where peace comes drumming slow, all alone with the ancient tones of William Smith Monroe. Now if you should go a-walking across the creek by the bridge and ramble through the woods up on Jerusalem Ridge, just listen to the birds and the lonesome wind that blows, carrying the ancient tones of William Smith Monroe. Now I hear his voice a-calling from somewhere in the pines, and that high lonesome tenor sends a shiver down my spine. As I walk the piney woods where peace comes dropping slow, all alone with the ancient tones of William Smith Monroe. Stand all alone with the ancient tones of William Smith Monroe.
Great Niall Toner from his CD Onwards and Upwards. If you're interested in any of the musicians and artists that you hear on our broadcast, all you got to do is go to woodsongs.com. If you click on the archive page, this is show number 722, and we'll give you all the information you need to know about We Banjo 3, about Niall Toner, as well as our next artist, three young guys. We're going to take a look at the how the younger folks feel about bluegrass music. Let's welcome Land's End to the stage. Let's talk to them. Give them a big hand. Three guys, young. Patty, Sam, and Richie. Let's talk to the banjo player, Patty Kiernan. Did I get that right?
Yeah, that's right. Yeah.
And you're playing. Unlike We Banjo 3, you're playing a 5-string banjo, bluegrass banjo. So where'd you pick that up?
I started 5-string banjo. It's quite popular in the ballad tradition in Irish music. Mm-hmm. So the likes of the Dubliners and the Clancy brothers would have accompanied themselves singing on the 5-string banjo. So I would have listened to a lot of that music, and the sound of the 5-string banjo just captivated me. And then I just sort of ended up playing bluegrass then
right.
After that.
Well, good. So who would you listen to? I mean, I'm sure there's not a lot of 5-string banjo players teaching around, right? So you probably had to learn on your own quite a bit.
I did. I'm quite fortunate that I've took a lot of tuition in a bluegrass music camp over in the UK called Sore Fingers Summer School.
Called what?
Sore Fingers.
Sore Fingers?
Yeah, yeah.
How appropriate.
A week of non-stop bluegrass. Yeah. So I've took lessons from the likes of Noam Bekelny and Tony Trishkin,
no.
Tony Furtado.
Mm-hmm.
So
yeah, best of the
very,
best.
Very, very fortunate. Yeah.
Yeah, best of the best. And all of them been on WoodSongs? Now you are on WoodSongs, right? So how do you find the community of bluegrass music in Ireland? Are there a lot of young folks like yourself part of it?
It's not a massive scene, but I think you'll see tonight as well, there's a lot of younger kids who are really coming along and sound great.
Right. Now, we have three members of Land's End. Let's talk to Sam Rose. Why don't you come on forward, Sam? Sam.
Hello.
Hey, everybody. So, you guys are just a little late. So Sam, you've got the acoustic guitar here, and Land's End is actually more members than what's on stage, right?
Yes, that's correct. We are three members of a band of five. We are currently missing, unfortunately, our lead singer and dobro player our dobro player is in America, so he might even hear this when this goes out.
We'll be passing him in the airport, no
yeah.
doubt.
Mm.
So the name Land's End, tell me about the name and how that applies to the band.
Well, we came up with this name because we wanted to reflect that the band is from actually several different countries. Our dobro player is actually German, as you can probably tell, I'm English. And we wanted a name to kind of reflect how far we come to kind of unite ourselves. Mm-hmm. So, and Land's End kind of gives that, you know, the end of land kind of feel.
Right.
If you rearrange it.
Right.
If that makes any sense to all of you. I'm sure it does.
Well, I tell you what ended was our time. So
sorry.
I'm just kidding. We also have a Richard Foley playing mandolin. So, Richard, you're doing sort of the Bill Monroe thing, right? It's the traditional style of mandolin that you play.
Especially for Neil's song there that time.
Yep. Land's End. Didn't they do a good job with Neil? They backed Neil up on his song. Very versatile. So let's get into your music. They're going to treat us to an unrecorded song. So you hear something fresh and new. It's called the Land's End Medley. Please welcome them, Land's End, to the WoodSongs Old Time Radio Hour. Patty, Sam, and Richie. Land's End, just absolutely wonderful. And you know what? We're going to go even younger now. We're going to skew even younger now into the world of bluegrass. And we want to welcome 13-year-old Evan Lyons to the stage, along with 14-year-old Tabitha Agnew. So Evan, you and Tabitha are both playing 5-string banjos, right?
Yes.
And so how old were you when you first started playing the banjo?
I was 12.
It was like a few months ago.
Yeah.
Tabitha, how old were you when you started?
10.
You were 10, so just a few years ago. So Evan, most guys who like want to like get older and have a girlfriend don't start playing the banjo right away. So, you know what you call a beautiful woman on the arms of a banjo player? A tattoo. So I'm just giving you a little hint of your future. But anyway, you two met each other today, right? The first time. And you practice a song that you're going to treat us as a duet. You ready to go? So we have Evan Lyons, 13 years old, Tabitha Agnew, 14 years old, both playing the five-string banjo on our stage at the Convention Center in Dublin, Ireland, and they're going to do a tune called My Grandfather's Clock. You've got to be proud of the kids. Evan Lyons playing with Tabitha Agnew, both 13, 14 years old. That's just a taste of what this broadcast is about. We're coming to you from the beautiful stage of the Convention Center in Dublin, Ireland. We're going to be back with our celebration of bluegrass music in the nation of Ireland right after this.
Hi, friends, this is your old buddy Ralph Stanley, and I'd like to tell you that you're listening to Michael Jonathan and the WoodSongs Old Time Radio Hour.
And welcome back to the beautiful Convention Center in Dublin, Ireland. We are coming to you from the land of the harp, and we are broadcasting worldwide. Let's say a big welcome to a fellow Yank from America, Tom Hanway. How you doing, Tom?
Pleasure, Michael. I'm doing great.
You're an American banjo player living in Dublin, living in Ireland.
In Longford, actually.
So how long have you lived in Ireland?
10 years now.
And how long have you been playing the banjo?
Since 1985.
Okay, so you started playing the banjo, then you had to leave America.
Right, yeah, they ran me.
Came to Ireland where you'd sort of the banjo witness protection program.
That's right. Well, I decided I wanted to collect tunes, so I'm sort of the Longford collector.
So you're sort of a scholar, like a
Well,
like
I
a
write
song.
Books. Yeah. I collect tunes. I have 3 books out with a publisher.
So we're talking tonight about the very unique musical DNA sort of connection between Irish traditional music and what became bluegrass music. And you get to experience that firsthand.
Absolutely. Well, a lot of it is just going to sessions and breaking the bread with the people who play the music. It's as simple as breaking the bread with the people that you meet at local sessions.
And what can we tell the audience? That what the germ of the traditional songs, that when the immigrants came to America, not referring to Irish folks as immigrants, but in America they were immigrants, and they come with their music, and Bill Monroe started a trend that turned that music into what is now called bluegrass.
That's right. Well, his own mother was a fiddler, and he used to say that she got a wonderful Scotch, which is sort of a misnomer, but a Scots-Irish tone out of the fiddle. And so he grew up learning from his mother, and he learned fiddle tunes.
And you are here tonight with a nice Irish acoustic guitar player, Alan O'Neill, and you're going to treat us to a song, unrecorded, another treat for our audience. He's going to do a tune called Going Back to the Blue Ridge Mountains. Please welcome him, Tom Hanway, to the Wood Songs, Old Time Radio.
I'm going back. I'm going back.
Gonna leave today.
Gonna leave today.
I'm going back.
I'm going back
to the Blue Ridge Mountains.
To the Blue Ridge Mountains,
honey babe.
Honey babe, I'm going away.
You can't be my little darling. You can't be my sweetheart now. You've been causing all the trouble. You don't love me anyhow. I'm going back. Mountains. I'm going back.
I'm going back.
Gonna leave today.
Gonna leave today.
Yeah, I'm going back.
I'm going back
to the Blue Ridge Mountains.
Blue Ridge
Mountains. Honey, babe, I'm going away. I'm leaving right by now. I'm going back.
I'm going back
to the Blue Ridge Mountains.
To the Blue Ridge Mountains.
I'm going back.
I'm going back.
Gonna leave today.
Gonna leave today.
Yeah, I'm going back.
I'm going back
to the Blue Ridge Mountains.
To the Blue Ridge Mountains.
Honey, babe, I'm going away.
Alan O'Neill on acoustic guitar, Tom Hanway playing the banjo, going back to the Blue Ridge Mountains. Good old song. We are turning the convention center. We're turning the convention center in Dublin, Ireland, into a huge front porch as we're celebrating bluegrass music and traditional Irish music. And we are certainly making a special conscientious effort to really highlight the young folks in Ireland that are taking hold of this traditional form of acoustic music, this wonderful thing. So let's welcome the next group up, so three young kids, brothers and sisters. They're called Cup of Joe. Let's say hi to them. You guys are... So, Tabitha, we already enjoyed your duet with young Evan. Didn't she do a great job? Wasn't that wonderful? So you're here with your brother Ruben on acoustic guitar and Benjamin playing the upright bass. Benjamin, how old are you?
19.
You're 19, and Ruben, you're 17, right? You can speak out loud. It's radio. It works. So how long have you been playing acoustic guitar? About 6 years, and you're playing a very unusual upright bass. Why don't you tell us about it? Looks like it's been on a diet.
Yeah, it's an electric upright bass. It's sort of, for the long car journeys, you can't really take a big one, sort of.
And it's a lot easier to carry, no doubt.
Yeah. Right.
So it's very thin. It doesn't have that big bell-like shape that most upright basses have, but it sounds good.
Yeah, basically a big pole.
Yeah. So now, tell me, like, in your family... There's probably not a lot of other families around that are like listening to bluegrass music, playing bluegrass music, or to play with, right?
Not really. We're basically the only people in around our area who actually listen to bluegrass mm-hmm. and know what it is.
So Tabitha, how did it start for you guys? Was it a mom and dad thing? Did they introduce it to you?
I think it was they brought us to the Bluegrass Festival in Oma, and I've been there since I can't remember when.
Well, you're only 14. There's not much you can remember.
No, I can't, yeah.
But you're doing so well. So you guys practice together a lot? I mean, like, do you do this instead of listening to Niall Toner on radio? You're practicing, right?
We're practicing. sorry. yeah, we're all homeschooled. We were all homeschooled until the point, so we just kept practicing all the time.
And what does it take for your mom and dad to encourage and support their three kids playing, you know, bluegrass music together and going to the festivals and the little bookings and stuff that you get? I mean, it takes a lot for them to do that, right?
I think it does, yeah.
So you thank them often?
Yeah.
You'd like to do that on the air, perhaps?
Thanks, Mom and Dad.
Thanks, Mom and Dad. Now, you guys have a brand new album, which we're going to introduce here, and you're playing a very old song that Benjamin is not a poetically, it's very pointed, the song is.
Yeah, it's a good tune. It's a murder ballad.
A nice murder ballad. As oddly enough, most folk songs are either, most of them are murder ballads. Why is that, do you think?
I don't know.
Somber?
They're somber, right. Well, you're playing a beautiful rendition of a very old song. It's from their CD, Rough Terrain. This is the classic tune, Darlin' Corey. Please welcome them, Cup of Joe, on the WoodSongs, Old Time Radio.
Preaching at Corey's funeral in some lonesome burying ground. Dig a hole, a hole in the meadow. Dig a hole in cold ground. Holy hole in the meadow, gonna lay down and call me down.
Reuben Tabitha and Benjamin Agnew, together they are Cup of Joe. If you want to know more about the artists that you hear on a broadcast, just go to woodsongs.com. If you click on the archive page, this is show number 722, and we can't do a show that talks about traditional music in Ireland without at least bringing up the harp and the button accordion, and we have one of the foremost traditional musicians in the nation, Dermot, and Flo is his partner, and she plays the harp beautifully, and she is from Paris, France, correct?
Yeah.
Prepare. Let's give them a welcome to the stage.
Thank you.
So Dermot, you were recently awarded a traditional Irish or traditional Irish musician of the year, correct?
Yes, I was very very lucky, very honored to receive the TG Carr Gradham Kyall Musician of the Year Award for 2013.
Well, you deserve some applause for that. And Flo, how does a classically trained harpist from Paris, France, make her way to Ireland?
At first, I came on holidays there about 8 years ago with friends, and I just, you know, came with my harp and started playing and in sessions, and I just ended up living in Ireland, so and practicing there.
So what drew you to the traditional music that you play? Because you're classically trained, correct?
Yes, I am.
So playing traditional music, classical musicians play usually from the chart, from the note,
mm-hmm.
right? Traditional musicians play from the heart. Their
yes.
chart is on their heart, right? So you're playing. So it's a different thing to learn for you, isn't it?
It was, yeah, actually, start of. My grandfather gave me a tape of Irish music when I was very young. I was about 11. And I start pick it up, you know, by ear. So that's how I did, you know, just by ear, like it's supposed to be.
Right. So. And Dermot, you're playing the button accordion. That's a very, very traditional instrument for a lot of Irish jigs and stuff.
Yeah,
yes?
That's right, yeah. Well, I mean, I probably started playing when I was about 5 years of age. So I've been...
Was this obviously in your family then?
Yes, my father played accordion as well.
Isn't it amazing how important family is to kids and their musicians? Like
that's
Cup
right,
of Joe,
yeah.
You know, their parents are really supporting them, which is nice, isn't it?
Yeah, that's what it's all about, I think, to pass it on to the younger generation.
Well, we're going to give you a chance to take your seats, and Flo is going to get behind her harp, and Dermot's going to pick up his button accordion. They are a great musical partnership. She, of course, is from France, now living in Ireland, and he's one of the most awarded traditional musicians in the nation of Ireland. Together, they're going to do a wonderful harp and button accordion duet called Sore Point. Please welcome them, Dermot and Flo, to the WoodSongs Old Time Radio.
Thank you.
Dermot and Flo, combination of France and harp and button accordion in Ireland as we're exploring the world of traditional Irish music and bluegrass music and just enjoying a beautiful, beautiful broadcast in your home country of Ireland. We love being here and we love you guys for being in the convention center. You guys are doing great. Good audience. Let's go back from whence we started, and these guys are just taking the Irish traditional music world by storm, the bluegrass festivals and such. Let's welcome We Banjo 3 back to the stage. Let's talk to Enda. We got two sets of brothers in the band, yes?
That's right, Michael.
So explain the pairing.
Well, Fergal is my brother. He's the fiddle player. And then you have Martin and David Howley.
And you are a Irish banjo champion.
I am.
Yes, might as well.
Thank you.
Take credit where credit is due.
Well, Martin has far more All-Ireland championships.
I was about to get to that. The We Banjo 3 is made up of stellar master musicians, all four of them, and you are really. Taking the idea of traditional music in a very contemporary way. You guys are doing great. So what are the rehearsals like for the four of you?
Well, we started out as a three-piece, which was three banjos.
Right.
And I couldn't win an argument because of the two brothers. So that's why we got Fergal in, and I still can't win.
Sort of defense.
Well, it's three against one now instead of two against one.
You're still losing, right? So is there a new album in the works? Are you touring a lot? What is the band doing?
We're about to head off to a huge American tour, and we're going to have a new album out in the new year, please God, if everything goes well, if we get home safe.
Well, we hope for the best because you guys are doing grand, and we're very proud of you, and thank you for being our broadcast. From their CD, Roots of the Banjo Tree, this is a tune, beautiful tune, called We All Need Kindness in This World. It's Banjo, We Banjo 3 on the WoodSongs, Old Time Radio.
In this world, oh, we all need more kindness in this world. You can look high or low, but there's
world. We all need more banjos in this world. We all need more banjos in this world. But you can look high or low, but there's no place else to go. We all need more banjos in this world.
Wasn't it great to have Wee Banjo 3 on the broadcast? Dermot and Flo, Cup of Joe, Tom Hanway, Land's End Bluegrass Band, Niall Toner, and didn't we enjoy the little duet by Tabitha and Evan? These are your kids that are playing this wonderful, wonderful form of music. They're yours. Years ago, a fellow would be sitting on his front porch in Rosie in Kentucky, and he'd be hearing his uncles and aunts play music as the music from Ireland and Scotland drifted into the Appalachian Mountains as people moved into America, and they brought their traditional sounds with them, their fiddles and their mandolins and their accordions, and this young boy named Bill would sit on his porch, and he'd start playing this on his mandolin, and he started to make friends with this music, as this music does. This music, bluegrass music, traditional music, folk music, is wonderful because the finest music is not played on the grand stages. It's played in the campgrounds and the parking lots of the festivals. It's the community of musicians. And Bill Monroe found that community, and he met Earl Scruggs later on, who's a wonderful banjo player. And bluegrass music was born. And he said something very interesting that's appropriate to tonight. As he was making his career and becoming more popular, he said, "Bluegrass has brought more people together and made more friends than any other music in the world." And don't you think that's true? Aren't we all friends? Isn't the world a nicer place because of music? Take the inspiration of people like Wee Banjo 3 and Dermot and Flo and all the other musicians on this stage. You can play too. I know a lot of the audience knows three chords and the truth. The greatest stage in the world is actually your own living room couch. Your children are the greatest audience in the world. Sing to them, play to them, and enjoy the grandness of the music of your own country. We love Ireland. My name is Michael Jonathan. I am a log cabin dweller and I'm a folk singer, and we'll see you next week on the WoodSongs. Thank you for tuning in. There are so many talented artists that appear on our stage. It's very hard sometimes to pick the ones that appear on our TV broadcast. So what we're going to do is leave you with a performance from our huge online archive of past shows. We'll see you next time on the WoodSongs Old Time Radio Hour.
I can hear his heartbeat from 1,000 miles, and the heavens open every time he smiles. And when he comes to me, that's where I belong, and I'm running to him like a river song. He gives me love, 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 crazy love. He gives me love, 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 crazy love. He's a fine sense of humor when I'm feeling low down. And when he comes to me as the sun goes down, he takes away your trouble and he takes away your grief. Oh, and he takes away my heartache the night like a thief. He gives me love, 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 crazy love. He gives me love, 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 crazy love. And I need him in the morning
I need him, and I need him in the night. Yes.
Closed captioning provided by visitlex.com. WoodSongs is made possible in part by Altec, makers of Kentucky Bourbon Barrel Ale. More information is online at kentuckyale.com. And by Tourism Ireland. More information available at ireland.com. By Time Warner Cable, providers of telephone, television, and high-speed internet nationwide. And by Kentucky Tourism. Information is online at kentuckytourism.com.